Hi, very good morning to you. How are you doing today? Hope you're doing fine. My name is Darren and I'm the English tutor from EnglishTuition.org. As you can see, I'm all dressed up because I'm going to create some video content for my students later on. But before I do that, I want to make a quick video about time management. So in the previous video, I've already discussed about the importance of being able to think fast and work fast. So that will put you in the student in a very good position to be able to complete the exercises that are being given to her in the test or the exam. So let's talk a little bit about time allocation. We will start with the PSLE. Now PSLE consists of two papers for the written papers. That's paper 1 and paper 2. Now in paper 1, students will have to work with the situational writing and the continuous writing. And they are given a total of 1 hour and 10 minutes. Now the weightage for the marks is as follows. Situational writing is 15 marks, 1-5, and continuous writing is 40 marks, 4-0. So as you can see, the marks for the continuous writing is more than 2 times that of the situational writing. So ideally, the student should be spending much more time on the composition writing. And that is rightly so, because the situational writing exercise is a relatively simple exercise for the PSLE. It is 15 marks, and out of the 15 marks, 6 marks come from the content and 9 marks come from language. So the 6 marks can be easily obtained by just following the instructions on the question paper. The students just have to make sure that they include all the important points as asked for by the question. And that will ensure that he or she gets the full 6 marks. Now, as for language, the student just has to be careful not to make many grammar mistakes or spelling mistakes, and make sure that all the sentence structures, punctuation, everything is done correctly, and then the student will be able to score for language. So typically, the score for a situational writing exercise at the PSI level is at least 10 and above. So if the student is scoring less than 10 for situational writing, then he or she needs to put in more effort to try and improve on the exercise. And for situational writing, the time allocated for this particular component is only between 15 to 20 minutes maximum, right? Because we want to leave more time for the composition writing part. And let's assume that the student takes 20 minutes to complete the situational writing section, then you take 1 hour 10 minutes, deduct the 20 minutes, so that leaves about 50 minutes to write the composition. So that's more than enough time for a student to look at a question, to plan, to think of a very good storyline, and to start writing and to complete the writing, all within the span of 50 minutes. Now bear in mind that the 50 minutes is all not meant for writing. We have to, as mentioned, we have to spend some time to plan for the story, to think about what we want to write, how are we going to end the story, what is the climax of the story, stuff like that, right? That is going to take up time. And the actual writing time typically takes between 20 to 30 minutes. It's that fast, right? Because the minimum word count for the composition section for PSLE is only 150 words. However, most students, if they want to do well in this section, they should write a recommended word count of about between 300 to 350 words, and they should not spend more than 30 minutes to complete the entire writing. And the reason why that is so, besides the planning, at the end of the writing, I always encourage students to leave some time, okay, to be able to go back and check on the mistakes. Sometimes when we are writing, we may not be aware that we have made some certain mistakes, or sometimes when we go back and check the work, okay, we feel that there are certain expressions that we may want to rewrite. And generally speaking, we just want to improve on the overall quality of the composition. So that is the PSLE paper 1. Okay, now as for paper 2, the time given for the PSLE is a lot longer. That's 1 hour 50 minutes. And the entire paper itself consists of booklet A and booklet B. Booklet A primarily just contains MCQ questions, and that can be completed very quickly. Booklet A is upon 28 marks, and the usual marks that most students get is about 22, 23, and rightly so, because MCQ is the part where a certain element of luck comes into play, and sometimes students can guess the correct answer and sometimes not. And the reason why they cannot score full marks is usually not because of the grammar section, and it's usually because of the vocabulary section. If certain words that you've not seen before, then you can only rely on guesswork. And if you're unlucky, then you will get the wrong answer. And that's what is preventing students from getting full marks for booklet A. Now, booklet B consists of fill in the blanks and some of the more open-ended questions like open-ended close passage and open-ended comprehension. This paper itself can be a little bit more challenging. The entire paper 2 is upon 95 marks. So you do the math, 95 minus 28, whatever the balance is, you know, that's for booklet B. And so the different components itself needs more time, and I recommend that students, when they get stuck, you know, on a certain question, for example, the open-ended close passage, that's a very common section to get stuck, because students find themselves spending a lot of time thinking of what are some of the possible answers, and if no answers come to them, right, some students just, you know, sit there and waste time, and no precious seconds and minutes just go by, and at the end of the paper, they find that they do not have enough time for the comprehension section. So just be mindful of that. Now let's very quickly move on to the O-level syllabus. So O-level syllabus, paper 1, paper 2. Paper 1 is 1 hour 50 minutes, and paper 2 is also 1 hour 50 minutes. So students need to work on their endurance to be able to sit through paper 1 and 2 on the same day, right? So my lessons are about 2 hours, and sometimes students complain that after 2 hours they feel so tired, they find themselves lacking energy, then they're not able to focus and concentrate on their work. So that's a little bit concerning, because the actual O-level exams require the student to take paper 1, take a short break, and then continue to do paper 2. Now imagine after taking paper 1, which involves a lot of writing, right, and it is quite possible that the student is already tired, that's where the mental fortitude comes in. So if the student has the endurance and stamina to be able to work and concentrate for long periods of time that is interjected with short breaks, then I think he or she has put himself or herself in a very good position to do well during the exams. And paper 1 itself consists of the editing exercise, which is 10 marks, situational writing 30 marks, and continuous writing 30 marks. So in total, 70 marks. Editing exercise, if students are already very familiar with the grammar rules, typically they can finish in 10, maximum 15 minutes, right? And they should not spend any time longer than 15 minutes, because they need to move on to the other components of the paper. And because situation writing and continuous writing for paper 1, they look to be about, you know, to have the same marks, 30 marks each, right? So some students think that, you know, it is fair to allocate equal amounts of time. But I personally recommend that students spend slightly less time on the situational writing. And the reason is because the word count requirement for situational writing is less. So for full-fledged essay, sometimes students can write, you know, about 500 to 600 words, and that can take up quite a bit of time. But for situational writing, whether it's an email or a letter, they can finish writing the entire piece of the exercise with a word count of about somewhere between 400, maybe slightly more than 400 words. So they are required to write less for the exercise. And a lot of the content for the situation writing has already been given and suggested by the questions. So what the students need to do is to start writing as fast as possible and try to spend slightly less time in the planning phase, because the requirements are already given in the question, and all the students need to do is to try and fulfill the requirements of the question. However, for the continuous writing, the essay component, the students have to choose one question out of four questions, and it's just a one-liner questions. There are no prompts. Okay, there are no pictures. So the students will have to spend more time to think and plan what are the points that I'm going to write. If I'm going to write an argumentative essay, which side am I going to take? Will my arguments be compelling? Will I be able to come up with effective rebuttals for the other arguments? Right, things like that, that the students will have to think before they can start their writing. And then on top of that, once they have planned for their essays, you know, they have to spend time to complete writing the maybe 400 to 500 words. And once they've completed the writing, they have to spend time to check through their answers. And then sometimes we find that we make mistakes, you know, certain paragraphs that we are not happy with, that we strike off. So all these kind of things require time. And if the student can work fast in the editing exercise and the situational writing exercise and complete the first two parts within 50 minutes, so that effectively leaves the student a full hour, 60 minutes to work on the essay, right? And I think there's a very good chance that the student will do well because he has the time to check through his answers, the time to think through what he wants to write, and less chance to make mistakes. And as for paper 2 is upon 50 marks, is open-ended comprehension. 5 marks come from visual comprehension. 20 marks come from the narrative comprehension, and 25 marks come from the non-narrative comprehension. And the non-narrative comprehension component contains a section that gives a lot of marks, okay, which is a summary section, which is 15 marks. So 1/5 out of 50 means there's quite heavy weightage there. And the entire paper itself is 1 hour 50 minutes. Usually students do not have time management issues unless they read very slowly and there are some words or phrases that they do not understand, or there are some questions that they do not understand, and then they find themselves getting stuck. So by the time they get to the non-narrative summary section, they find that they do not have time to work on the summary because the summary requires them to write 80 words. That's the maximum word count. And that's some work to be done. You need to identify the points. You need to think of how you're going to organize and paraphrase these points. And all these thinking activities will require some time on the part of the student. And if the student gets stuck in the earlier section of the paper, then he's going to run out of time. So how to go about doing that? Right, recognize that there are certain questions that the student may not have the answers to. So the trick is not to get hung up on these questions. Okay, that's the usual advice that I give to my students, and to move on. You can always come back to the questions later when you have more time and when you have completed the entire paper. And that was what I used to do when I was a student, right? You just maybe circle, make a mark by the side of the question, and then you just move on. So you give yourself a reasonable amount of time to try and work out the answers on the spot. If not, then you have to move on. You cannot afford to get hung up on certain questions, because by the time you get to the summary section, okay, you must give yourself enough time to finish the entire paper. So I think that it is always very unfortunate to hear students come back and tell me that, sure, I don't think I'm going to do well because did not have enough time to finish the paper. And if you did not attempt the summary section and give it your best shot, then it is very likely that maybe you will just get a borderline pass or maybe even fail the paper. So let me know what you think of the time management tips that I have for the students in the comment section below. I've come to the end of the video, and after this I'll be moving some of my equipment outside to make some more new content for my assisting student. And if you would like to see more videos just like this one, please head on to my YouTube channel, subscribe to the channel, or you can follow me on my Facebook page. Give it the video a thumbs up or a thumbs down. And thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.